here, 3v3 Calderis Refinery blue team. Got a couple of Imperial God players. First up is Slaaneshi Cacophony as an Inquisitor who's not moving. She is a offensive commander, really good control abilities and a bit of support thrown in too. Begins in melee combat but can get ranged weapons. There she goes. This is the Steel Legion elite scheme. The other Imperial Guard player is Deckard as a Lord General. Fights ranged combat, begins with a retinue of stormtroopers to help him out. Can add to this retinue throughout the game. Really good defense and support capabilities. And in the center is the Great Cornholio as a Plague Champion. Starts off range combat with a damage of a time bolter. Can get melee weapons, some decent utility and support. Can build turrets and repair, but is very slow. Red team, HansMoleman as a Warlock, a melee commander that can leap into combat. Some good disruption and mobility with some powerful support thrown in too. This is the Harlequins elite scheme alongside Hunter as a Hive Tyrant, very durable commander, walks through objects and cannot be suppressed. Some good offense, disruption and support. Begins in melee combat. And rounding off the teams is Bruce as a Force commander, very good offense, fights in melee combat, can also tank, disrupt and support with buffs. Lots of convergence on the center right now, which is not usually seen at the start of refinery matches. We see a Plague Champion in the mid. It can be tough for Plague Champions when they are the central player on refinery. It's a big map, relatively speaking. It's quite open and the bases are far apart, so it can be tough for the Plague Champion to support both sides. Now the same can be said for the Hive Tyrant, who's not exactly quick, but he can mitigate that with towers. And I think he's going to want to put down tons of towers as soon as he can in tier 2. Just spam towers and rudeness. That's all you should spend your red on, I think, as a Hive Tyrant on this map, especially if you're the mid player. Rudeness are so good here. Cornholio gets doubled and is forced off the mid. Meanwhile, on the west side, there's the Immolate going to take down that Luz turret. The Immolate from the Warlock. From his Immolator, it is. There's the Sentinel Stomp. Stuns the Warlock for a decent amount of time, as you can see. It's 4 or 5 seconds, I think. Spore Mines on the field for Hunter, knowing he's up against a bunch of Guardsmen and potentially a bunch of Heretics, but Cornholio only has one Heretic squad. Could still be really bad for them, though. 500 to 489 early on, and a Hive Tyrant is on decapping duty. Really good early pressure from the red team. Great start for Hunter. Push the mid through. And now he's coming to the east side and he's going to help, I think, force off Slaaneshi. Yep. Fought well. Got the Hormogots down pretty low, but only took 2 models. Going to lose the Laz turret. Plague Champion finds the Hive of Turret capping. Actually stops him from finishing a cap. And now we see the bow is spew up. It is tempting on this map because you can try and get their both the powers. You can get this one and just stroll over here and get this one, but it's pretty open, which means he's going to get shot at a lot and he needs to get close to use that bow spear. And with ranged Raveners already on the field, it may suggest that we're going to see a ranged Tyranid blob from Hunter with the Venom Cannon in tier 2 maybe and some ranged Synapse. So that's going to shoot down that Plague Champion pretty quickly, even if he's fully kitted out with Pestilence and stuff. Inquisitor getting into combat with some tactical marines, and they lose a model there. Assault marines jumping in after them though, and that's bad news for that blob of guardsmen. They have spotters in there as well, but he needs, I think, maybe another sentinel over here, because that guy's getting shot down by tactical marines and scouts. He needs to keep that sentinel back to help against the jumping assault marines. Grenade almost on friendly fire there. Some Nurgle worship then allow Cornholio to push forward to the heavy cover here. Nurgle units love heavy cover. Heavy cover and Nurgle worship is awesome. No other wargear Plague Champion quite yet. We might see the Mucus Discharge to give him that extra sustain in the field and also help those Imperial Guards to stay in the field a bit longer. Look at this from Hunter though. He's back and forth from the left and right with those Raveners leading the charge. He's got some decent mobility other than the Hive Tyrant, and he can only make that better with some capillary towers. Here's a Burrow Strike from the Raveners, and there it is. not forcing melee combat. The heretics are right there to counter initiate. The Plague Champion focusing on trying to keep that Hive Tyrant control, and he does well. He fought that engagement well, Cornholio, forces off the Hive Tyrant. It all started because he hit the Bilious Discharge very well on the Hive Tyrant and forced those Ravenous to jump before perhaps they wanted to. It's always better to try and get your Hive Tyrant into combat first, draw fire, and then Burrow Strike your Ravenous in. That's not always viable, of course. Often you'll have to try and initiate with your Ravenous, which is not ideal because they're going to get focused down pretty quickly. Middle is uncapped. It's 484 to 440. VP is relatively close, but you get the feeling that the red team have had the better of it early on. Lots of pressure on blue team's natural VP. Maybe it's just because I've been watching this more. What's going on west side? Looks like Deckard is going off the red team's VP right now. Yep, the Lord Drenal himself is going to decap it. And there we see the medical sergeant retinue member who can hand out medical packs. Ouch. Immolate and a destructor. Loses a retinue member. The Lord General himself will always die last, which makes him pretty durable in the field usually. Quite difficult to take down the Lord General, unless he's just not paying attention, I guess. Down goes the Inquisitor. Has the Holy Brazier you see there, which is a power weapon, and gives her the Holy Pyre, which is an amazing ability. Debuff and damage over time for a hell of a long time. I mean, to get that 20% damage debuff for the 20 seconds or whatever it is amazing area denial. You don't want to fight in that thing at all. Smoke shell, well, he's just been overrun by two players here. Slaaneshi, you see what I mean? Much more difficult for Cornholio to support both sides fluidly. Just takes an age to get out of base as a Plague Champion. I have Tyrant on capping duty. Havoc's a little bit unlucky to only suppress one of the squads there. It's a Termagant Brood that gets suppressed. I assume we have double Toxin Sacks. Yes, we do. Hunter did lose his Hormigaunts along the way. Oh, this is a nasty flank from HansMoleman. What is he up to? He's come mid and he's going to double grenade those Havocs, maybe. No, does not. Didn't even try to leap on them with the Warlock. Cloak of Shadows is queued up for tier 2, and that is a nasty flank. He might wipe these heretics with a grenade throw. No, does not even attempt it. Is it on cooldown or something? Really strange to see Hans not use his grenades at all in that engagement there. Oh, CSM in retreat now. Was he waiting for that? 461 to 395. This could be nasty. And it, oh, there we see it. A little bit late with the throw there, I think. Takes that one model though, and goes after the gens. 454 to 395. So it's basically 3v2 here. Deckard is left to bash the gens himself. And Dire Avengers are defending. It's triple Dire Avengers of hands into a Shuriken. We have double Flamer Guardsman. He's really committing to that power bash. And the Sentinel with a missile launcher here. Slaaneshi already has a Manticore on the field, and that could be nasty. Triple cap now for red team though. Blue team ready to ramp it up in tier 2. Zone Throat already on the field. Venom Brood coming to give that raid synapse. What are we going to see on the Hive Tyrant though? He's done really well considering he has no war gear whatsoever and he's up against a Bilious Discharge and an Inquisitor that can stun you with Hammer of the Witches and stuff. Plague Champion now fully kitted out with Fetid and Mucus Discharge. Pretty solid build. More durability so you can get closer with the Bile Spear, and you're not quite as slow as you would be if you had the Pestilence. A Air of Effect heal is never bad, of course. Plague Marines on the way for Cornholio. Expecting maybe a Space Marine vehicle. Usually, if I'm up against Tyranids, although I guess he's not solely up against Tyranids, he's up against multiple players in a team game, but usually you want to get lots of anti-infantry stuff against Tyranids. They would help against a Tyrant Guard if it showed up. 378 to 395. I think he should have gone for some blood letters there, Cornholio. Deckard with Stormtroopers. We will see how that turns out. I think that's a risky choice. I would have gone for some Ogryns or a vehicle, because the Immolator into the structure is really going to hurt any Stormtroopers, and they're going to be a prime target of HansMoleman now. And we have Wraithguard, which are easily going to outshoot anything Deckard can put on the field. So he needed to get them Ogryns up, I think. He has the... No, he doesn't have spotters to shut down the Garni weapon team. Maybe that's why he didn't get the Ogryns up. Chimera and Ogryns, maybe it would have been better. We will see how it pans out. Bruce still with only 3 units on the field, but they are keeping the pressure up here. Plague Marines on the field now, recently got their bolter damage buff. They only get 2 bolters in the squad though, so it's not a massive, massive difference, but a nice little bonus for them in 2.4. Such a strong unit, Plague Marines. Although I really would have gone for some bloodletters. Maybe he did not see the zone throat yet. Might get shot down here though, and nice usage of the black grenades that he switched back into. Look at that. Got a few models, did tons of damage, so that stuff is now going to be in base healing up. He's going after gens, I think. Uh-oh, Thunderhammer Force Commander is on the prowl with the teleporter as well. Makes him so difficult to deal with. He pretty much counters the entirety of Cornholio's army with a Thunderhammer teleporter pack combo. He can teleport on the Havocs, and if the Heretics counter initiate, they're going to get wrecked by the Thunderhammer. Down goes the Hive Tyrant, maybe. Uzaki's only just going to get away. No, goes down thanks to the damage of a time of the Plague Marines there. Heretics do get away. He used Touch of Nurgle just in case, but that's going to turn out to be a wasted global there. 150 red down the drain. Deckard just lost a bunch of stuff. I'd imagine a lot of that had to do with the Wraithguard here.
Sir, we're losing a victory point out there.
I mean, surely he's got to expect the Wraithguard. Really should have got some Ogryns up, but I guess Ogryns are not super, super easy to use. But he does have the support of the Lord General. He could have got the anti-suppression armor, walked alongside the Ogryns and sent them in to crack some skulls. But it's gone tier 3, and tier 3 is a great thing for Imperial Guard. Lehman Russes all day long. They're all going tier 3, in fact, the blue team. The Zonothrope is still around, and there's not really anything on the field that can go after it. I mean, it could get hit by a Manticore Dragon, of course, and it can always get caught unawares and shot down. But if Hunter is on his game, that Zonothrope should be relatively safe. 378 to 246. A 2-1 cap for the blue team. They're holding VPs here. They really are holding VPs. And here comes Cornholio through the mid. Level 2 Plague Champion. Ravenous Court. And they are wiped out super, super quick. Wow. HansMoleman asking his team to focus on transitioning to the mid. Bruce saying they need the power over there. 378 to 229. Bad engagement for Hunter. Almost lost his double termagants. Might still lose them in retreat here. Maybe not. Kill Space Marines using their slaughter, I think, to try and fight that Warlock, but they do get away in the end, having to run from multiple Dire Avengers and that Thunderhammer. Down goes a Plague Champion. Stayed in the engagement a bit too long there. Havocs are there though to try and stop that cap. And Deckard coming back out of base. He's trying to recover with a heavy weapon. Oh, it's just Guardsman. He's got a heavy weapon squad already with an auto cannon. Lord General getting way too close to the Garnet weapon team. Not sure what he was trying to do there. Just draw its fire, maybe. Infiltrated stuff thanks to the Cloak of Shadows. That is a nasty combo. Infiltrated Wraithguard is terrifying. Just open up with those volleys out of nowhere. 378 to 192. Blue team have the VP advantage going into tier 3 here. They've been pushed back a lot on both sides, but Cornholio has done a great job last 5 to 7 minutes or so holding this contested VP. Level 3 Force Commander now has the Artificer to make him even more annoying. And you see there the debuff of the Holy Pyre even affecting vehicles. 378 to 178 Manticore Strike, nicely done. Killed a bunch of Termagants, forces off almost the entire army of Hunter. The Zonthrope is still around. Hunter goes tier 3. Chaos Predator already on the way for Cornholio. I guess just give it the Mark of Pawn, though he might not give it any mark quite yet. It's often a better idea not to give a mark immediately and try and push the advantage with another unit quicker. 371 to 178. Down goes the Sentinel, surely. Yes, got hit by a haywire, which is not great for Sentinels in general. Looks like he wants to kill some stuff and not bash power. He's caught the Havocs. Cornholio is getting flanked pretty badly. Black Grenade on the Assault Squad. They are really low. And if only those Heretics were closer to the Plague Champion, he could have finished off those Assault Marines, I think. 353 to 178. Holy Pyre again doing work against a big blob of stuff. Ogryn's now for Deckard. Pretty late Ogryn's there. And a Hell Fury Strike helps back off the Tyranids. Here's the Chaos Predator. He's gone for Mark of Nurgle. Gives it a massive list of benefits. Huge amount of health. 75% more health and health regen and mana resist. Does get two less speed though, and its shot now spreads this disease type stuff, which is worse versus large targets and vehicles in general, but can do some work for you against infantry, especially light infantry, because it's probably, does it tell me here, it's probably flame damage, yeah, flame DPS. 313, 178, now a triple cap for red. HansMoleman flanking in, doing a lot of work there. Here comes some Ogryns. How much fire can they draw? How much work can they do on this west side and flanking inwards? We've seen very little of Deckard in the middle, actually. Whereas Hans, using the mobility of Eldar, able to get in there a lot more often. Slaaneshi has a Lehman Russ. Dreadnought taking shots. No capillary towers whatsoever for Hunter. Able to contest all areas pretty well without them so far. The Hive Tyrant now fully upgraded with Crushing Claw, improved Synapse and Warp Field. Crushing Claw, of course, was dropped to 150 requisition in 2.4, which is great for the Hive Tyrant. Makes it a lot more attractive compared to the Venom Cannon now. Going after the tank? No, he's forced off. See how much damage this Hive Tyrant soaked up though. That was crazy. Is he going to get away? Damage of a time. Finishes off the Hive Tyrant there. Thanks to those Plague Marines. Bunker is immediately stolen by, I think, Assault Marines in there. Nope. Yes, it was Assault Marines. A nice grenade. Was that a grenade? Yes, from the Plague Champion. I'm always confused by Black Grenades because they don't give the Plague Champion the grenade icon if he also has the Bile Spear. It's a bit of a bug. Same deal with the Chaos Lord. If he has the Combi Flamer and Armoury Inferno, he won't get the grenade icon. Swarm Lord on the way for Hunter. But Blue Team have some pretty beefy armies right now. They have a Chaos Predator, they have a Lehman Russ, they have a support bunker there for reinforcements. They have Havocs with an autocannon, which is strangely spread out. Can the red team break through here? Dreadnought getting shot down. Is he going to chase it? He should try to. Yes, down goes the Dreadnought. Nicely done from Slaaneshi. Good little push here. And there's Purgatus. Hive Tyrant is forced off and taken down again. Was just revived by the Force Commander. Down he goes. Blue team looking strong here. Are there any nukes available? Yes, both. I think Bruce. Does Hunter have one? Hunter's close. Bruce could drop an orbital, which could be good on this bunker type area. 250 to 141. Blue team looking strong with a 2-to-1 cap here. Ogryn's doing a good job, it looks like, since they've hit the field. Wraithguard trying to tank them with the help of... Oh, it's just their Wraithbone. I thought that was Channeling Runes as well. But it wasn't. Just the Wraithbone. And they survive. Ogryns are though soaking up so much damage there. We have some Marco Zink CSM without their aspiring champion running into trouble here. What's he up to? Does get away in time. Red team have a lot of stuff to push now. This might be the push that forces off the blue team. We shall see. Focusing fire well so far. Chaos Predator hitting objects there, I think. Now the shots are getting through. Massive engagement. Swarm Lord getting involved. The Salt Marines jumping in. What is that? Is that a singularity? It was a singularity, but did not get anything caught in it. Swarm Lord, a super unit for Tyranids, allows them to reinforce off it and gives them a great speed synapse. Manticore doing work. That was frantic stuff. But in the end, it looks like Red Team take mid. Both the naturals are with their respective owners, but maybe not for long. Look at this, it's going after the Manticore, is it? No, decides not to. Does have some Terminators up. Red Team's natural is going to get pushed. Stormtroopers and the Lord General himself going after it with some guards with it, and Hans is completely off the field, I think. Yeah, healing up after a painful engagement, so they're going to at least get a decap down there, I would think. Meanwhile, though, northeast, the Thunderhammer Force Commander is on capping duty. Heretics not going after him. They are worshipping a shrine. Is that... are those tank shots even getting through? Oh, look at this. Chaos Terminator's in the field. They can now retake that point. Slaaneshi is forced back into his base, but he did not lose his Manticore or Lehman Russ, which is the important thing. Got a lot of resources, Slaaneshi. Might be thinking about that Baneblade, and Cornholio, I'm sure, is thinking about getting the Plague Fist up to help him cap. Especially alongside these Chaos Terminators and some worship and stuff. Hans comes back out of base, but not in time to stop the cap of that VP. Did he kill something? I don't think... oh, we took out the Stormtroopers. Stormtroopers are... no, they're not. They're down here. I'm looking at the wrong roster. There they are. Double cap was briefly a triple, I believe, for the blue team. 222 to 69. Can the red team get back into this? There you see that speed synapse affecting the Hive Tyrant himself, which it makes the Swarm Lord great choice for the Hive Tyrant. The Hive Tyrant charging around is pretty scary. Massive engagement here. That is a great target for a nuke. Do any of them have one though? Pergatus goes off. D-Cannon, I think, is taken out. No, D-Cannon gets away. And they're going to finish the cap on the mid. Yes, they are. Wraithguard getting shots on the Lehman Russ. What is it doing? Goes down. Swarm Lord going to get some rear arm hits on the tank. Nope. Just ignores it. Massive, massive push by the red team. Wow. Did not expect them to get through this easily. If only the blue team had a nuke. There's a rocket run. Takes out nothing, I think. Wow. Didn't quite get that second run in the right place there. Tank is now being chased down by the Swarm Lord, but with Mirror Resist, it should be able to withstand it unless it chases all the way into base. No, it does not. 195 to 53. This engagement is still going. Slaaneshi lost his Lehman Russ, is now getting a Baneblade up though, and it's almost here. That's going to be a big, important unit. Ogryns are going to wipe on retreat. 186 to 53. Imperial Guard players losing stuff left and right in this engagement here. Ouch. Can be hard for Imperial Guard to sustain themselves in the field, but the Lehman Russ should not have been that far forward, I think. Oh no, Bruce, forgetting about his tactical marines, goes down on retreat. That was a shot from the Inferno pistol finishing him off, I think. The Inquisitor is almost level 7, wow. Plague Champion halfway through, level 5, Lord General at level 4 with some grenade launchers and carapace armor. He's got to stand firm now. 163 to 53. Hive Tyrant is leading the line and causing absolute havoc here. Manticore strike makes the Tyranids back off, but they're still in play. and we don't see any brood nests, really? There's one capillary tower there. Banebait is on the field. Don't be too hasty with it. There's a Wraith Guard around. And where there's a Wraith Guard, there's potentially an Eldritch Storm. So it needs to be really careful with this thing. 144 to 53. Bruce asking for a nuke. Nothing quite yet though. Hunter has one, but that's not going to do a whole lot versus a Baneblade. 134 to 53, Singularity on the mid. Stops the Plague Marines trying to cap there. Ouch. Melter Bomb on the Baneblade. The Soot Marines smacking it with their Chain Swords and Power Sword. They run straight into a Manticore Strike. Ouch, that was painful. Didn't get a model, but there's Purgatus. And the Baneblade is stuck, I think. Cornholio can't come over and help out, though. He's fighting some Tyranids and stuff. Baneblade does get away in the end. 126 to 53, Fire Prism. A massive pain in the arse on this map. This kept at maximum range can be very difficult to approach that thing. This engagement never stops in the center. 126 to 53. Blue team running out of steam, I think. Predator tank does get away. Terminator still around. That Swarm Lord has been really good for leading the line for the red team. Really good. When you send your Swarm Lord and Hive Tyrant in, and then you've got all this shooting stuff behind, not even mentioning all the Eldar stuff. Got some Cyclone Missile Launcher Terminators. They will help greatly versus the Baneblade if they can get close enough. Looks like they might be going in for a strike. There it is. Baneblade backs away enough. Yes. Actually some friendly fire on the Swarm Lord there, I think. Cyclone Missile Launcher did not hit at all. 119 to 53. Blue team taking a natural back, but can they get them contested back? I think it's up to... It might be up to Deckard to push the flank here. Much easier said than done, especially when the Fire Prism can take out a Lumen Rust from there. That was crazy. Okay, Plague Champion with Plague Fist is capping. He has the Armor of Pestilence as well, so the Fire Prism can't knock him over. There's the Pestilence Strike. Was waiting for stuff to actually start shooting him before he used it. Double Zone Throats here for Hunter. This one's being chased down. There's Purgatus. May I be able to finish it off with that Inferno Pistol? Not quite. 107 to 48. 2-1 now for the blue team. They did get their mid back. Plague Fist could be the difference in this game. It could be the difference. In fact, he's completely changed his loadout here. Has Armor of Pestilence and now Icon of Nurgle. He's purchased all three of the Plague Champion accessories. And they've all done a pretty good job for him as well. He's hit a couple of good black grenades. The heal was always useful. I think I would have kept the Mucus Discharge. But he wants that Icon of Nurgle to damage stuff, I guess. He should not have used Pestilence Strike there, I think, because now the Power of Tyrant is benefiting from it. But I guess he wanted to keep the Plague Champion in there a little bit longer. Chaos Terminator is in melee with a Force Commander. Could just about see him there. 105-25. Massive engagement again on the mid. Chaos Predator has just been happily sitting here for ages, but now it's under attack. Wow, it's gonna go down. 94 to 25. That could be GG for the blue team. Cornholio cannot hold against two players. Where is Deckard? Deckard completely off the field here, going after the natural. Hans has attacked the mid at just the right times, and Deckard has barely been anywhere in the mid. Now trying to cap with the Commissar's retinue shield up, but gets knocked off it by a grenade and cannot finish the cap. Manticore goes off, triple though for red. And look at their armies, I think they've won this now. Only 41 VPs to take down. Hive Tyrant trying to be really cheeky and get a decap on that wreck point late game. GG there, called by Deckard and HansMoleman, and red team are going to take it with a triple. Massive, massive fighting in the mid. But Deckard was never really here in any great capacity. Seemed to lose his important units at just the wrong times. And red team do take it out. It was a rocket run at the end, I think. Maybe it was only a Basilisk creeping barrage. But there you have it. Let's look at the heroes. End of the game. Level 8 Inquisitor had the mandate there to try and cap at the end. Level 6 Plague Champion with huge amounts of war gear. Deckard's Lord General, level 6, grenade launcher's Carapace. Level 7 Warlock had the Immolate and Cloak of Shadows and Heart of Darkness, so Enhance was being used. Did not personally spot it myself. We have Hive Tyrant, only level 4. Seemed to do a lot of work though, draw a lot of fire, but I guess you don't get XP for being shot at. And a level 6 Force Commander with the ever annoying Thunderhammer Teleporter Pack with Artificer as well. There you have it, guys. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And I'll see you next time.